السيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. Indeed, all praise and glory belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We praise Him, we seek His aid and His forgiveness. We seek refuge in Allah from the evils inside of us and from our evil actions. Whomsoever Allah guides, none can lead astray. And whomsoever Allah leads astray, none can guide. I testify that none has the right to be worshipped but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He is one and He has no partners. And I testify that Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is His servant and final messenger to the whole of mankind. My respected brothers and sisters in Islam, a key principle in our lives is to remember the akhirah, the life to come. We are surrounded by this dunya and we spend often all of our time, all of our efforts, all of our thoughts on how can I progress and improve in this dunya. There's nothing wrong with that. But at the same time, we need to remember the permanency, the foreverness of the next life of the akhirah. And often we forget that. So the purpose of the khutbah today, inshallah, is to remind myself and my respected brothers and sisters about the life to come, al-akhirah. So when you talk about the life to come, one can talk about preparing for death, one can talk about the grave, one can talk about standing on the day of judgment, but I don't want to talk about any of these things today. I want to talk about our eternal home, either Jannah or Jahannam. This is the topic of the khutbah, Jannah, Paradise and Jahannam. In the first khutbah, we will learn about some of the descriptions of Paradise and Hellfire. And very interestingly, in the second khutbah, there are many conversations that take place between the angels and the people of Paradise, between the angels and the people of Jahannam, between the people of Jannah and the people of Jahannam, between Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the people of Jannah and Jahannam, and we will look at some of these conversations in the second khutbah, inshallah. So we begin by looking at Paradise. It has been described in the Quran in Surah 43, verse 71. There they will have all that the souls can desire, all that the eyes can delight in. Anything that you can imagine and beyond that is waiting for you in Jannah. In a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what no eye has seen, no ear has heard, no heart has imagined. Imagine the greatest scene. Imagine listening to the beautifulest thing. But Jannah is more than that. Jannah is beyond what you and I can imagine. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised this for the believers. Some of the descriptions of the homes in Jannah, we're told in a hadith in Ahmad, they will have bricks of gold and silver, and mortar of fragrant musk, pebbles of pearl and sapphire, and soil of saffron. Whoever enters it is filled with joy and will never feel miserable. He will live there forever and never die. His clothes will never wear out and his youth will never fade away. SubhanAllah. Look at this, the description of Jannah. Bricks of gold and silver, pebbles of diamonds and sapphire, beauty, youthfulness that will never go away, clothes that will never wear out. All of this is waiting for the people of Jannah. In Quran, Surah 18, verse 31, they will be adorned therein with bracelets of gold, and they will wear green garments of fine silk and heavy brocade. They will recline and rest on raised thrones. How good is this recompense and a beautiful couch to recline on? So imagine this, they will have thrones, they will have couches, they will have the best clothes, they will have gold, all of them they can imagine is waiting for the person in Jannah. Surah 88 verses 10 to 16. There will be a running spring. There will be on thrones raised high and cups set at hand, cushions set in rows and rich carpets all spread out. Imagine on thrones and cushions and the best carpets and the best drinks and the best food and drink. Allah says in the Quran, eat and drink at ease for what you have sent forth in days past. This is just some of the descriptions of Jannah, beyond what you can imagine. So when you think of the best house that you want, the house in Jannah is infinitely better. When you think of the best designer labels that the young man wants, the clothing is Jannah, is infinitely better. All of this is undescribable beauty in paradise. The things that harm us in this dunya, things that are unclean, you know, mucus and bad smell and disease and illness, all of this will disappear in paradise. Again, we're told in the hadith in Sahih al-Bukhari, they will never fall ill, never blow their noses or spit. Anything that you find in this life of discomfort, blowing your nose or spitting out or falling ill, all of this will be gone the second you enter into paradise. We're told in the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in Sahih al-Muslim, when they enter Jannah, a caller will cry out, indeed, may you be healthy and never be sick again. May you live and never die again. May you be young and never grow old and feeble again. May you enjoy and never feel sorrow and regret again. All the things we dislike of old age, of sorrow, of discomfort, all of this disappears when we enter into Al-Jannah. So in the dunya, the man strives to be healthy, he exercises, he eats well, all of these things. But one day, he will become ill. He tries his best to remain youthful, she puts on all these creams, one day she will become old. In Jannah, none of this. An eternity of never becoming old or painful or any kind of discomfort. In Jannah, you will have social relationships, you will have emotions and feelings, but pure ones and of brotherhood. Again, we're told in Quran in Surah 56, verses 25 to 26. They will in there never hear any bad speech or sinful speech, only the saying of Salah. No bad speech, no lying, no swearing, no backbiting, none of this. All of this will go the second you enter into Jannah. Allah says in Quran Surah 7 verse 43, we shall remove from their breasts any hatred or sense of injury, any bad feelings, any harm, any injury will be gone from your heart. In Sahih al-Bukhari, there will be no hatred or resentment amongst them. Their hearts will be as one, and they will glorify Allah morning and evening. Their hearts will be at one. You know, sometimes you arrive, you go on Hajj, and everyone is doing the same thing. Everyone is believing, and it's a beautiful feeling. Or you come to the masjid 27th night, everyone is believing, everyone is doing good. It's a beautiful feeling. You're united as one heart. In Jannah, this is how it will be. No arguments, no disagreements, no hatred. We will be, inshallah, one brotherhood, united with the best kind of feelings and emotions. We're told that the relationships that we have in the next life, they will be forever. Maybe our parents have passed away, our wives, our children. Maybe they are still alive, but the relationship is strained. We're told in Quran, Surah 13, verses 23-24, gardens of perpetual bliss. Perpetual means it's forever. So Allah's promising you gardens of perpetual bliss. They shall enter therein, as well as the righteous amongst their fathers, their spouses, and their children. See the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The believer, he'll be reunited with the righteous and the good one from his parents, from his wives, and from his children. And together, they will enter into Jannah, and the angels will greet them from every gate. We're told in Quran, Surah 4, verse 69, and whoever obeys Allah and His Rasul, they will be with the ones amongst whom Allah has bestowed His favor, of the prophets, of the truthful, of the marchers and the righteous. So in Jannah, you will be with, inshallah, the prophets, the truthful like Abu Bakr as-Siddiq, the righteous and the martyrs. These will be your companions in Jannah. Imagine a place that you enter with your parents, your wives and your children. And around you are the best and most noble of places. And the home is the best, and the food is the best, and the clothing is the best, and the feeling is the best. All of this is waiting for us in paradise, al-Jannah. And the converse or the opposite of this is what? Jahannam or hellfire. Let us do the same. Let us look at some of the descriptions of the punishments of Jahannam and how the people will be those that enter into this most miserable of places. So we begin by in the Quran, Surah 66, verse 6. Allah saying, O you who believe, save yourselves and your families from a fire whose fuel is men and stones. So you know a fire. A fire has fuel. Normally you throw wood on it, the fire burns higher. This is the nature of fire. Fire needs fuel. The fuel of the fire of Jahannam is men and stones. Men and stones will be the fuel of this place. In a hadith, the Prophet ﷺ said, fire as we know it, as you and I know it, is 1/70th part of the fire of Jahannam. So imagine 70 parts, the fire of this dunya is 1/70. Just imagine the intensity. One of the companions said, Ya Rasulullah, it is enough as it is. You're not a fire, you can't put your hand in a fire for a few seconds, your hand will get burned. So the companion says, the fire, this dunya is as enough as it is. He said, it is as if 69 equal portions were added to the fire as we know it. It's the fire of Jahannam. We cannot stand for a second, a few seconds, the fire of this dunya. The fire of Jahannam is 70 times the intensity, the pain, the suffering of the fire of this dunya. In respect of Jahannam, it's described as a roaring, raging creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In a hadith, we're told, hell will be brought forward that day by means of 70,000 ropes. Each will be held by 70,000 angels. Imagine the size of this roaring, raging creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As for the punishments of the fire, just as we had the reward of the people in Jannah, of their clothing of silk, of the best food, of the best drink, of the best home, the opposite awaits in Jahannam. Allah says in Quran, Surah 22, verse 19, those who have disbelieved will have cut from them garments of fire. Clothing will be made of fire. Poured over their heads will be scalding, boiling water. The worst, hottest type of water will be poured over their heads. Their clothes will be of fire. We're told in Quran, Surah 14, verse 49 to 50, you will see the criminals, there are criminals on that day, bound together in shackles, garments of liquid pitch, and their faces covered by the fire. No food will be there for them, except for a bitter, thorny plant, which neither nourishes nor avails against their hunger. So they are hungry and they are thirsty. They will be made to eat from the worst bitter type of plant, and it won't satiate, it won't get rid of their hunger at all. Before him is Jahannam, who will be given a drink of the boiling water. He will gulp it, but hardly be able to swallow it. And death will come to him from everywhere, but he is not to die. And before him is a huge punishment. Imagine this, clothing of fire, chains all around him, food that will burn him, liquid that will be poured over his head. All of this is awaiting the people who disbelieve and disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This life is serious. We behave as if it's a game. This is the problem. Many of us, we behave in this dunya as if this is a game, and as if there is no consequence. Over and over again, we are reminded, you only have to pick up the Quran about the seriousness that is awaiting for us. As for the least person, imagine the least person who will enter Jahannam, we're told his punishment. The person who will receive the least punishment amongst the people of hell on Yawm al-Qiyamah will be a man. A smoldering ember will be placed under the arch of his foot. So you know the foot is small, the arch, the bit, there's a small little ember, a tiny part of the fire, just an ember, tiny part of his fire. His brain will boil because of it. He's the least person
being punished in Jahannam. There is a tiny part of the fire under a small part of his feet, and his brain is boiling. This is the punishment of the least person in Jahannam. You can only imagine the punishment of those that are in greater punishment than this. We're told again in Quran, the criminal, why is his crime? His crime is not believing in the one who created, the one who fed, the one who sustained, the one who gave everything to him. He denied him, he is a criminal. Allah says in Quran, the criminal will wish that he could be ransomed from the punishment of that day by his children, by his wife, by his brother, and his nearest kindred who shelter him, and all that is in earth, so that it could save him. He would give up everything. He would give up his own family to be saved from the punishment of Jahannam. But no good it would be here for him on that day. This is the punishment of the hellfire that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised those that disobey him. أقول قول هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفر إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين الصلاة والسلام على رسول الكريم. So throughout the Quran, in the hadith of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, we see many conversations taking place. Many conversations. I will go through briefly just a few of them. First of all, the conversations that take place with the angels. So the person, he's about to enter Jannah, and the angels, they speak to him. And those who keep their duty to their Lord will be led to Jannah in groups. So me and you, inshallah, those who obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be led into groups into Al-Jannah. Till when they reach it, and the gates will be opened, and the angels and the keepers will say to them, As-salamu alaykum. You have done well. Enter therein to abide forever. Imagine this beautiful greeting. Alhamdulillah, you made it. You did it. Salamu alaykum. Enter for what you put forward in the life of this dunya. As for the people of Jahannam, similarly, the angels will speak to them. Allah says in Quran, Surah 67, verses 8 to 10, it almost bursts with fury. Jahannam is bursting with fury and anger. Every time a group is cast therein, the keeper, the angel will say, did no warner come to you? Did no warner? Of course, the warner came to us, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The angel will say, did no warner come to you? They will say, yes, indeed a warner, one who warns, came to us. But we belied him. And we said, Allah never sent down anything. You are in great error. So they said to the messenger, you are in great error. And they said, they will say, at that time, the people of Jahannam will say, had we listened and used our intelligence, we would not be the dwellers of the blazing fire. Subhanallah. They will say on that day, if only we had listened, if only we used our aql, our intelligence, today we would not be burning and humiliated in the fire. So today as you listen, my respected brother and my dear sister in Islam, listen, use your intelligence. We do not want to arrive on that day and in front of the angels, the only thing we can say, if only I had listened, now is the time. And we're told again in Quran, surely the disbelievers will be in the torment of hell. It will not be lightened for them, and they will be plunged into regret and sorrow and despair. You know, it's horrible to feel regret and sorrow. In Jahannam, the people of the fire will have regret. They will have despair. They will say, if only that we wronged them not. Allah says, we wronged them not, but they were the wrongdoers. They will cry out. The people of Jahannam will say, O Malik, the keeper of the hellfire, let your Lord make an end to this. Let us die. Let it die. Death is better. Let your Lord make an end to this. He will say, surely you shall abide therein forever. Indeed, we brought the truth to you, but most of you have a hatred of the truth. Most of the people today, they have a hatred of the truth. They deny it, they turn their back. This is what we said to them. The truth came to you, but you hated the command to obey Allah. to establish tawheed, to establish salah, to do that. You hated it, you didn't do any of this. You turned your back on it. And there will be conversations between the people of Jannah and the people of Jahannam. We're told again in Quran, Surah 74, verses 40 to 47. In paradise, they will ask about the guilty. They will say, what caused you to enter the hellfire? The people of the hellfire, they will be asked, what caused you to enter the hellfire? They will say, listen to what they will say. We were not of those who used to pray. We didn't used to pray. These are people of the hellfire saying this now. What was their case? We didn't used to pray. Nor did we feed the poor. Nor we used to talk falsehood with vain talkers. We used to belie. We used to deny the day of judgment until death came to us. That is certain. So look at the characteristics of the people of Jahannam. No salah. No giving food. No helping the poor. Talking, chatting rubbish all the time. Not knowing, denying the day of judgment, the akhirah. For this they enter the fire. This is what they say. When they are asked, the people of Jahannam, what was it that landed you here? And if today we exhibit these characteristics, we don't pray, we don't give food to the poor, we're chatting rubbish every time, we know nothing about the akhirah, what are our characteristics like? Conversations take place and the people of Jannah, inshallah, they will talk to each other. They will approach each other inquiring. Allah says in Quran Surah 52 verses 25-27, they will approach each other. They will say, before this, we were afraid with our families, but Allah has been gracious to us and saved us from the torment of the fire. And they will come, they will speak to you. Before we were worried, where will we end up? Alhamdulillah. We're told in Quran, in Surah 35, verses 34-35, they will say, all praise and thanks. When the people of Jannah, they are speaking to each other now. All praise and thanks be to Allah, who removed from us our grief. This dunya is a place of grief. All praise be to Allah, thanks to Allah. He removed us from our grief. Verily, our Lord is indeed oft forgiving, most ready to appreciate, who out of His grace has lodged us in a home that will last forever, and where toil will touch us not, nor will weariness touch us. They will say to each other, Alhamdulillah, Alhamdulillah, Allah has been kind to us. Allah has saved us from grief. Allah has put us in a home that will last forever. Allah has removed any suffering from us. Imagine the beauty of this conversation of the people of Jannah. As for the people of Jahannam, they will blame each other. There are many ayat in Quran. We'll just briefly do one. They will turn to one another. On that day, the people of Jahannam, friends will become enemies. They will accuse each other. One will say, you came to us from a position of power. The weak one in Jahannam will say to the one who had power in this dunya, you came to us in a position of power. They will say, no, it was you who did not believe. We had no authority over you. You were exceeding the limits. Our Lord's sentence on us is just, and we must all taste the punishment. We led you astray as we ourselves were astray. Everyone will blame each other. Even Shaitan, there is a verse in Quran, Shaitan will say, I had no authority over you except to call you. You responded to my call. Everyone will blame each other in Jahannam. Everyone will blame. This is the regret, the suffering, the pain. As for the conversation, Allah will speak to the people of Jahannam, we're told. The people of Hellfire, the Quran Surah 23, verse 106 to 108. They will say, our Lord, wretchedness has overcome us. We were a people astray. Our Lord, remove us from it. And if we were to return to evil, we would indeed be wrongdoers. They will ask for Allah's mercy. He will say, remain despised therein and do not speak to me. Even the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is turned away from the people of Jahannam. Allah will say to them, do not speak to me. They will say, one more chance. Like we say in this dunya, someone comes to you, akhi, start praying. Bro, you know, be good. Bro, don't look at me. Bro, one more chance. Someone passes away. I'm going to change my life. I'm going to be much better. One more chance.
So they will say, in Jahannam, they will say, one more chance.
Allah will say, no.
You had your chances over and over again. Every time, every Jummah, every week, every day you picked up the Quran, every time you had it, you were warned, one more chance.
No, there will come a time, no more chance. It's reality, there will come a time, Allah says in the Quran, no more chance.
Don't take this life as a game. Don't take it as playing about. This is serious matter. The messages didn't come with a joke. This deen is very real. Life is real. Akhirah is real. Remember it. Conversations will take place between the people of Jannah and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The last person who enter Jannah, who like have the whole world and all that is 10 times, a conversation takes place, will move on inshallah. Just 2 more conversations where Allah will say to the people of Jannah, after they've made it now, Allah will speak to them. Allah will say, oh people of Jannah, they will respond, here we are, our Lord, and all good is in your hands. Allah will say, are you satisfied? Imagine Allah's asking the people of paradise, are you satisfied? They will answer, why shouldn't we be satisfied when you have bestowed on us what you have not bestowed on any of your creation? He will say, shall I not bestow upon you something even better than that? They will say, oh our Lord, so they've seen the homes of Jannah, they've had their clothes, they've had everything, what can be better than this? They will say, oh our Lord, what can be better than that? Allah will say, I bestow upon you my pleasure, and I shall never be angry with you. The pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for eternity is with the people of Jannah. Allah is pleased with them, and they will live forever in peace and in security and comfort. This is the reality, my respected brothers, my dear sisters in Islam. The permanent, the eternity is to come. This is a life of struggle and of trial. Set your lives right. Allah is the most merciful. Ask Allah for forgiveness of your mistakes. Allah is the most kind. Turn your life around. Establish salah. Feed the poor. Be a good Muslim. Establish good relationships. Jannah is waiting, inshallah. اللهم اغفر لنا ذنوبنا وكفر عنا سيئاتنا اللهم قنا عذاب الدنيا وعذاب الآخرة اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار وأقم الصلاة